Well, good Friday morning, everybody. Hi, it's Phil Kincaid. I'm here for the Telegraph with our favorite meteorologist, Al Caprillion. And Al, coming in this morning, it's a little dicey out there. We got a little snow coming down. What's going to happen?
Well, Phil, we'll have accordion to up to an inch this morning. The snow should end before the morning's over. Later in the morning, towards noontime, it'll be moving off the coast. This is due to some warm air coming in aloft, a little bit of overrunning, a little disturbance in the atmosphere. Doesn't take a lot of snow, even a half inch, three quarters of an inch, you can have very slippery roads, and that'll be the case this morning. We do have a flood watch in effect for our region Saturday afternoon through Sunday afternoon for 1 to 2 inches of rain. That's urban and poor drainage flooding. Any of the catch basins that have snow or ice will cause some flooding. Also, the rivers in New Hampshire we're going to be watching, because with the warm weather and the heavy rain, there could be some ice jams. So that could cause flooding. So if you live near a flood-prone river, you want to be alert this weekend, Saturday and Sunday, because flooding exists. Flood warning exists. You have to evacuate because flood waters are very dangerous. So something to keep an eye on this weekend. Today, we'll have a period of snow this morning, then mostly cloudy this afternoon, low 30s today. Tonight, we may have a little freezing light drizzle or freezing light rain after midnight into tomorrow morning. Could get a little slippery again tomorrow morning with a light ice accretion possible. Lows tonight near 30. Probably upper 20s to low 30s. So any light precipitation overnight, first thing tomorrow morning, could be icy, especially extreme northern Massachusetts, southern New Hampshire. Watch that tomorrow morning if you have some morning errands to do. And then during tomorrow, temperatures will rise to the 40s, near 50 late in the afternoon. The rain will get heavier late tomorrow afternoon. Heavy rain Saturday night. Could even be an isolated thunderstorm, 1 to 2 inches of rain. It'll be very wet and windy, gusty southerly winds. We have a strong low-level jet stream, so strong winds and heavy rains for the Patriots game. And Sunday, we'll see the sky become partly to mostly sunny, middle 40s. Phil, and we'll see if that mild weather lasts into early next week. So Sunday's definitely the nicer of the two weekend days. But the Patriots game, it looks very wet and windy. Not the Arctic air we had this week, but it's going to make conditions on that field are going to be very soggy.
Well, I can guarantee you one place that's going to flood.
Where?
My driveway.
Yeah, well, It's been a rough winter, but that polar vortex has lifted north. That is, again, that persistent large-scale cyclone or low pressure that brought cold weather all the way to Florida. You know, it was in the 40s at lunchtime, low 40s in Tampa earlier this week. So that vortex has taken the Arctic air back towards the Arctic Circle, at least for now. So,
I think for the most part, if we can get some warm temperatures, people won't mind the rain.
That's right, but we just have to watch the flooding, especially the ice jams on the rivers this weekend. So that's pretty much it, and we'll see Monday morning how long this mild weather and January thaw is going to last.
Okay, thanks a lot, Al. You have yourself a great weekend. We'll talk to you Monday and get a look to see how long we can expect those warm temperatures to last.
Have a great weekend, Phil, and everyone. Go Patriots!